we're going to look at different types of diseases that there are. We're going to look at them based on symptomology. Before, we were looking at pathogens and where the pathogens fell in. Now we're going to look at diseases. When we deal with diseases, basic thing we talked about before, necrotic, necrotroph, necrosis, biotroph, biotrophic. We're looking at the difference between things that kill the cells and then colonize them, or kill the cells as they are colonizing them, versus the things that don't kill the cells while they're colonizing, which means they're producing haustoria, they're stealing nutrients. Eventually, the cell will end up dying. We're going to look first at different types of necrotic type diseases. We always talk about damping off. Damping off basically occurs when you have a plant or a seed that is brought along with pathogen. As that seed has pathogen, it transmits that pathogen to the root system or the collar region of the plant. It provides for death of that particular plant. Remember, when they're in these small stages, they're quite young, they can easily be damaged. When they are easily damaged, they can die. Damping off becomes extremely important as a type of necrotic symptom. One seed kills everything. This is another picture of a damping off. You can see how this seed was never able to get out of the soil. It transmitted pathogen in that area. Now the pathogen is there, but the seed never got up. It never grew. This is another picture of damping off. You can see how the pathogen took care of the collar region right at the base of the seed. As it did that, it killed off the plant before it ever even had a chance of getting up out of the ground. When you have something like that, it causes total destruction of that plant. You get no yield out of it. You have transmitted the pathogen to that particular area. A necrotrophic type disease. Necrotic symptoms. We can see necrotic symptoms on a leaf. This shows you leaf blotch. We can show you necrotic symptoms on a pine tree-like material. This is called a needle cast. What's going to end up happening is the needles are going to fall off of this tree, but they're really very severely damaged. We can see necrotic symptoms. On the left-hand side, we have what we call a blight. A blight is rather a large lesion that is uncontrolled. It takes out a large area. The potato here has got what we call a scab. The scab is basically where the outer part of it looks like it's covered with scabs. It's a necrotic type symptom that damages the outer part. The inner part may still be fine, but the outer part now has a certain real rough texture to it. This is a turf grass area with a patch disease. A patch disease is interesting because rather than looking at the symptomology on a single spot, you see a bunch of plants together giving you a type of symptomology. This actually looks like a bunch of plants and you can see the symptomology among them. This is called a patch disease. It is a very problematic, rather than just having one plant that's got the problem, have a whole bunch of plants together that have the same problem. If you get up close, you can often see the mycelium in here. You can see the mycelium growing on living tissue. You can see the mycelium growing on dead tissue. Either way, it's very problematic. Down here, we have what we call melting out, a scenario where we get a patch type disease on a large area. It looks like the grass just melted away. So we call it melting out. We have leaf spots, a lot of different types of leaf spots. What we deal with is an angular leaf spot. This is where it is bounded by the veins of the leaves, so it kind of looks angular in shape rather than being a round sort of thing. We have leaf spots that are more rounded. These become very interesting as well. Another thing we look at on this particular leaf on the left-hand side is it is producing a toxin. Notice how you've got a lesion and then you've got a large area coming off of it that is also dead. This is a toxin type material produced by the fungus that causes a death of that tissue. So therefore, this is a little bit beyond being just a simple leaf spot. This is a necrotic type symptom. Over here, we've got a leaf spot, which looks again to be bounded by the veins, which would make it more of an angular type leaf spot. This is a very interesting leaf spot. It looks like it's on cherry. You can see how it's got the concentric rings in it. It's necrotic. It is death of the tissue. Through the death of the tissue, you get the symptomology appearing. Another leaf spot, you can see that this is much larger. It is round. We have different formats like that. We can have necrosis of fruits. This shows you black rot. This is caused by a fungus. It's causing withering of the grape. It's actually causing it to break down. You can see the spots on the outside. The spots are actually signs of the pathogen. You could identify it. This is gray mold on raspberry. You can see these raspberries don't look too good. Basically, what happened is a fungus got in and decided to destroy the tissue. This is a necrotic type symptom. Anthracnose is a very common type disease. It's a very specific disease that is caused by certain fungi that produce acervula. The acervula, if you go back and you look at it in the mitosporic fungi, occurs when you get a formation under the epidermal part of the leaf or the epidermal part of the tissue. It erupts out of there. This is a quince. You can see how you've got the concentric circles in here. Each one of these little dots in here is actually an acervulus. Inside of the acervulus, you've got lots and lots of spores. If you were to take one of them, pull it out, and look at it, you would see something like this. It would have lots of spores on the inside, may have these elongate things that we call setae that are basically a fungal material coming up that allows for identification of the different type of fungus that you would find. This is a banana. This is what you call butt end rot on a banana. It is very common. It is the same material that causes the little flecking on the banana. You can see these little flecks in here. Those are necrotic spots. This infection actually occurs in the field when the banana is just forming. The hard green banana skin allows the pathogen in, but it can't develop. This infection occurs in the field. After you bring the banana home, the banana has had a chance to ripen, then the pathogen starts to grow again, and as it does that, it forms these nice little round spots. If you let it go, then you'll get this thing here on the end. This piece of banana was intentionally left to grow like that. Looks real nasty. The pink material are the acervula that you can find on them. A necrotrophic type pathogen. When we look at necrotrophic type pathogens, you get death of the tissue, and that allows the pathogen to feed on the plant material.